In this video, we're looking at a problem where we're given a force versus position graph. And this is describing the force on a 1.5 kilogram cart that's sitting on a level track. We're told the cart starts from rest. And in part A, we're going to use the work energy theorem to find the final velocity of the cart at the end of this process. And in part B, we take advantage of kind of a special case here. This is a constant force, which means the acceleration is constant. And we can use the equations of constant acceleration kinematics to compute the time for this process. So in this work energy part, well, the total work done on this cart is the area bounded by the force position graph. And that area is just a square. It has a height of 5 newtons. It has a width of 5 meters. And we end up with 25 newton meters or 25 joules of energy pumped into this cart. Again, this force position graph is kind of a special case. It's just a constant force. So you could have just said work is equal to force times displacement and you would get the same answer. Then we apply the work energy theorem. So the work we pump into this cart results in a change in kinetic energy. And that change in kinetic energy, that's always final minus initial. And the initial kinetic energy was 0 because it started from rest. The final kinetic energy is 1/2 mv² for the final velocity, vf. So we have the total work pumped into this cart is equal to 1/2 mvf². We solve for vf. Just multiply both sides by 2, divide by m, and square root the result. And we get the square root of 2w over m. And now we just plug in the numbers, plugging in that mass of 1.5 kilograms there. And we end up with a final speed of 5.77 meters per second. Now in part B, we're asked for the time it takes for this process. And we have to realize the acceleration is constant because the force is constant. And we can write down the acceleration. That's a equals f over m. If you're used to writing Newton's second law as f equals ma, all I did was solve for a there. And this constant force is 5 newtons. The mass was 1.5 kilograms. And we end up with a constant acceleration of 3.33 meters per second squared. Now, because the acceleration is constant, we're allowed to use the equations of constant acceleration kinematics. So we can write down the equation of motion for the cart. That's x equals x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at². And we'll call the initial position 0. That means the final position is 5 meters. The initial velocity is also 0 because the cart started from rest. And we can solve for t in general. I multiply both sides by 2, divide by a, and square root the result. And we find that t is the square root of 2x over a. And when we run the numbers on this, we get about 1.73 seconds. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.